Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how easy it is to create ombre cards, and I will be using for that the new inks that have just been released by Pinkfresh Studios. Now they have released 48 inks in total. There are 12 color families, and for every color family you get 4 shades of the color, so from the lighter all the way to the darker. All the colors are available in the full size as the one that you see on your screen right now, but they are all available as ink cubes as well, which are way cheaper and of course easier to store. And this is premium dye ink, which means that it doesn't smudge when you use your watercolors or your markers, and it dries fast. Now if you want, you can of course make your swatches. I'm going to show you here an image where you can see all the colors in color families. And of course down below you will find links to everything. Now this is part of a blog hop, so make sure to visit my blog because there are lots of giveaways to be won. Now I'm going to pull 3 of those shades, the reds, the greens and the blues, and I'm going to make some ombre cards so you can see how quick and easy it is to create fun backgrounds with inks and then just pull together a card. Now I'm starting with the shades of red. And with my ink pad, I go directly on the paper and just swipe a couple of times. I'm going from the lighter to darker, and I make the swipe a couple of times just to make sure that I covered up completely my cardstock, and I also overlap the previous color. Now it is really easy to clean it up, and I'm working on a non-stick mat here. And now I'm going to grab the green shades and I'm going to make another background. Now this time I'm working with fresh pear, grassy knoll, key lime, and the darker is olive. If you want to have perfect results, you can always use masking tape to divide your paper in 4 areas and just swipe there so that you have completely defined lines in between the colors. I just like this look, so I'm going directly without any masking at all. Now I'm going to clean up my mat again and move on to the blues. And this time notice that I'm going to swipe my ink only once, making sure that I press enough to get a good coverage. And you will find that at the end it's going to look more defined in between the colors. Now I ended up having 3 different backgrounds, and all of them dried really quickly since this is a premium dye ink. And with these backgrounds you can just stick a sentiment or a big focal point and you have a card pulled together really quickly and easily. Now I am going for holiday cards today, which are really quick and easy to make, so they are great for mass producing, while at the same time they are going to look really beautiful. So I'm going to do some splashes, and this is white gesso diluted with water. I love this technique for Christmas cards because it always gives the illusion of snow at the background, and at the same time it adds lots of interest. So I'm going to repeat the same process for all the 3 backgrounds. I'm going to turn my backgrounds into cards. For that I will be using the wreath from the Layered Wreath die set, as well as sentiments from the Classic Holiday Words. And both of these products are from the latest release by Pinkfresh Studio. I did use the wreath in another video in last week, I believe, and I'm going to link to that at the end of this video. So I'm going to stick down my red panel, then I'm going to stick the wreath that I die cut. And I'm using just Nouveau Glue at the back. In the same wreath die set there are little dies that you can cut out leaves, so I cut out lots of them from different cardstock, and I'm going to spread them all around my wreath and stick them down. As a sentiment I'm going to use the word joy, and that comes from the joy and cheer sentiment, but I'm just going to use the first word. And finally I'm going to finish off my card by adding some glitter nouveau drops in red color all around the wreath. Moving on to the blue background, and again I'm going to stick this panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. Notice that all my panels are slightly smaller, so I end up having a white border. This time I die cut the wreath from white cardstock, and this would work great if it was glitter cardstock, white glitter cardstock as well. Now, if you notice, the Bimmer sentiment is the same color as the darkest of the inks on my background. I just swiped again the ink pad on paper and then die cut my sentiment. Now I'm finishing off my card by adding some blue gems, and here is a finished look. And moving on to the green and last card for today. So again, I'm sticking my background down with tape adhesive at the back. I die cut my sentiment out of gold cardstock and then the outline out of white. And I stack one on top of the other, and this is going to be a big, nice focal point for my card. I'm going to embellish it a little bit more, and I'm going to use these die cuts that I did from the Wreath die set. And I created my own cardstock to cut them out, so you see they match perfectly with the colors at the back. I just swiped again the ink pads on top of white cardstock. I cut out the dots from red glitter cardstock, and I'm sticking everything down. I'm also going to stick the darker of the leaves at the top so they contrast with the background. And then at the bottom I'm going to do the same thing, but this time with the lighter leaves, again for some contrast. Creating ombre backgrounds are really quick and simple to make. You can make so many different color combinations, and just by sticking any focal point that you have on top, you can have an instant card. So here are all the three cards that I made for today using the swiping technique. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for visiting today, and don't forget to leave me a comment and check out my blog post, since there are lots of giveaways to be won. Thank you all for watching, and have a lovely weekend.